going to start talking about circular economy right from the basics. And in case you have any questions, you can just type in the chat section of this window, and I will take up accordingly, right? And the whole session would be divided into three parts. That what is circular economy, why we need it, and how we have to adopt circular economy. So these are the three aspects which I'm going to cover. So what, why, and how. So first of all, just to start with circular economy, we need to understand what are the different type of economies are there in the world. So majorly and primarily there is one economy which is known as linear economy, right? And linear economy, to understand circular economy, first of all, we have to understand a linear economy first. And what is linear economy is? Linear economy, in a very simple term, is take, make, use, and dispose. This is a linear economy. We take the resources from the nature, we make a product in a factory, then we sell it into market that the users use to buy it, and then they use it for a certain period of time for the lifetime of the product, and then they go for the disposal of this product. This is a linear economy, which is widely accepted economy in most of the countries, and most of the countries are practicing linear economy. India is one of the country which have adopted this linear economy way back. China, these are some big giants and some of the big users of linear economy, that we collect the resources from the nature, we convert those resources into a product in an industry, that is make step, and the next step is sell in the market and use it and then dispose it. This is called linear economy. Now, what is circular economy? Circular economy, in this, take, make, and use, then it goes to reuse and recycle. We don't have a word dispose or a waste in circular economy. So that's the difference between linear and circular. Now the question is, why today we are talking about circular economy, and most of the developed economies in the world, most of the developed countries in the world are talking about circular economy today. Why? Because मैं ये सुनते हुए बड़ा हुआ, और मैं जब पढ़ रहा था स्कूल में या फिर कॉलेज में, तो मैंने ये सुना कि मतलब ये समझा कि जो ह्यूमन बींग्स हैं वो इस यूनिवर्स के सबसे सेंटर बायोलॉजिकल प्राणी हैं. ह्यूमन बींग्स आर मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्स एंड दे आर होल्डिंग इट. बट ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम ह्यूमंस आर नो मोर अ सेंटर ऑफ यूनिवर्स. The center of universe over a period of time is technology, and we are so much entangled with technology that we have started exploiting the universe natural resources, and that's a big challenge. Now, what are the challenges in linear economies? Why we wanted to shift from linear to circular? In linear economy, when we manufacture any product, after that, when the life of the product is completed, it has to go for a dispose of. Now, by setting the pace and the subject, most of you people may think that circular economy is something where we have to talk about recycling, where we have to talk about remanufacturing, refurbishment. No, not exactly. Recycling, refurbishment, reuse is a part of circular economy, but it's not the core of the circular economy. Circular economy is something different. Now, to understand the circular economy, the basic step which you have to understand is a nature. Basically, Nature is also a manufacturer. It's a kind of manufacturer. Nature, just to understand this entire circular economy, you have to take the nature as a system. When the nature is as a system, so nature is a factory. And just imagine about water cycle. It's circular. Just imagine about the food cycle. It's circular. And when anything, any cycle, any process becomes circular, it becomes stable, it becomes sustainable. But we humans have adopted a linear economy where we don't have a closed loop system. We are taking from the nature, but we are not passing back to the nature. And that's an imbalance which is created. And that is why there are a lot of problems now created, like climate change. And even if I'll not talk about climate change, I'll talk about economies of the countries are getting overburdened. They are getting overused. They are getting pressurized. And the best example, you can see the European economies. Okay, the increase in population. Okay, we have a limited resources, but population is increasing. So what happens with the increase in population? Basically, when the population increases, there's an increase of demand. And when there is an increase of demand, resources are limited. The land on the earth is limited. The trees, the forests, everything is limited, right? So when we keep on withdrawing the resources from the earth and we are not giving back to the earth, then there's an imbalance. And that's what is happening with most of the countries now. So most of the developed countries now are started thinking about circular economy, like US. Europe is a big contributor for circular economy. They are the basically a heart of circular economy, and they are the I can say they are the people who have basically given a birth to the idea called circular economy, right? So I have told you the two models of the economy. Number one is a linear economy, and number two is a circular economy. Linear economy is, I have told you, is a take, make, and use and waste or dispose. And circular economy is take, make, use, reuse, recycle. Okay. So now we are going to talk about how many types of waste are there. So when I try to classify the types of waste, okay, so there are two type of waste. One is the biological waste, the another one is a technical waste. So the biological waste basically follows a cycle of take, make, and consume, right? And then it has to go back to the nature. That is a step which is known as enrichment. So when we take anything from the nature in a biological form, we as a human, we consume it, and then we bring that biological back to the nature. Okay, that is the biological waste cycle. The another thing is the technical waste. Technical waste, for example, the wire, the hard disk, the memory, the laptop, the computer, the mobile phone, these all, after the use, they becomes a technical waste. Now, technical waste has to be recycled, has to be reused, right? So there are two type of waste, biological waste and technical waste, and these both of these two waste should be taken separately, that how we are going to use this waste and how we are going to use this waste from linear economy to a circular economy, right? So to start thinking about the circular economy, the main driver which we have to think about is cut down on the waste. We have to cut down on the waste. That is the number one. So any process which we are designing, or anything which we are designing, it should not have a waste in the process. We should minimize on the waste, number one. Then then we have to start thinking about sorry then we have to start thinking about what we can do with how we can start thinking about the circular economy. So circular economy basically have the six steps. So what these six steps are, okay, number one is regenerate, then a second one is share, थर्ड वन इज अ ऑप्टिमाइजेशन, फोर्थ वन इज अ लूप, फिफ्थ वन इज अ वर्चुअलाइज्ड, एंड लास्ट सिक्स वन इज एक्सचेंज. ओके, नाउ आई विल गिव यू ट्राई टू गिव यू सम बिजनेस मॉडल्स ऑन दीज सिक्स स्टेप्स: रीजनरेट, शेयर, ऑप्टिमाइज, लूप, वर्चुअलाइज एंड एक्सचेंज. हाउ दीज सिक्स स्टेप्स ऑफ सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी कैन बी अडॉप्टेड इन आवर बिजनेस इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ. ओके, सो नंबर वन इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी इज रीजनरेट. इन रीजनरेशन आई विल गिव यू एग्जाम्पल. बेसिकली स्कॉटलैंड इट्स प्रोड्यूसिंग, स्कॉटलैंड इज अ कंट्री विच इज द हाइएस्ट प्रोड्यूसिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ विस्की एंड बियर प्रोडक्शन. ओके, सो दे यूज अ लॉट ऑफ व्हीट, मेज एंड अदर फाइबर बेस्ड क्रॉप्स फॉर गेटिंग द एक्सट्रैक्ट्स ऑफ विस्की एंड बियर. सो देर इज अ यूनिवर्सिटी इन स्कॉटलैंड, दे हैव स्टार्टेड अ प्रोसेस कॉल्ड होराइजन प्रोटीन मैथड. वॉट इज दिस होराइजन प्रोटीन मैथड इज बेसिकली वेन दीज फैक्ट्रीज विस्की एंड दी बियर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फैक्ट्रीज, दे यूज टू टेक आउट दी एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम दिस व्हीट, मेज एंड बार्लेज. ओके, सो द लेफ्ट आउट एक्सट्रैक्ट दिस होराइजन प्रोटीन मैथड यूज टू एक्सट्रैक्ट दी रेसिडुअल प्रोटीन फ्रॉम दैट एंड प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द विस्की एंड बियर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. एंड वॉट दे यूज टू डू विद दैट, आफ्टर बाई यूजिंग दिस प्रोसेस, दे यूज टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द प्रोटीन आउट ऑफ दैट. एंड दिस प्रोटीन इज बेसिकली यूज फॉर मेकिंग अ फिश फीड, मछलियों का चारा. दिस इज वॉट इज अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रीजनरेशन. द अनदर सो रीजनरेट द इकोनॉमी, दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. द अनदर स्टेप इज अ शेयर इकोनॉमी. शेयर इकोनॉमी इज अ वेरी बिग कॉन्सेप्ट एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्रीज एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द कंपनीज आर मेकिंग वेरी बिग अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट आउट ऑफ दिस शेयर इकोनॉमी कॉन्सेप्ट. वॉट इज शेयर इकोनॉमी कॉन्सेप्ट इज ट्राई टू थिंक अबाउट उबर एंड ओला कॉन्सेप्ट. उबर एंड ओला इज बेसिकली अ शेयर इकोनॉमी. आई डोंट हैव अ कार, आई डोंट ओन अ ड्राइवर, बट आई कैन पे पर यूज, इज अ शेयर इकोनॉमी. राइट, इज अ शेयरिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमी. देन अनदर थिंग इज लाइक अनदर एग्जाम्पल एक्सेप्ट उबर एंड ओला, अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज रेंटो मोजो. रेंटो मोजो इज अगेन इंडियन कंपनी एंड दे हैव स्टार्टेड अराउंड 5 years back in the all metro cities. And what they used to do is basically they have entire household equipments with them, household devices, household requirements like mattresses, beds, fridge, cooler, AC, everything, right? And you can rent out, right? So these are the example of share economy, right? Then if I'll go for international examples, okay. There's a company called WeWork. What is WeWork? WeWork is basically they create an office space of 500 people, and you are a startup, you have started your company, and you don't have a money to set up an infrastructure, an office, a sitting space, an internet, an air condition, and everything. So what you can do is you can go to the WeWork and you can ask them, okay, I need a 10 seats. And WeWork will provide you a full-fledged office space with 10 seats where your people can go and work and come back. This is again a very good example of share economy. So this is what is called a share economy. Okay. And maybe another example I can give you is there's a company called Airbnb. It's an international company, Airbnb. I think most of you have heard about that. And Airbnb have more than 6 million customers worldwide. Okay, what they used to do is, for example, you have a 3 BHK flat, but you are using only one bedroom or two bedroom, but you have one bedroom empty, or it can be captured, it can be rent out, right? So you can, what you can do is you can go on Airbnb, you can just register yourself, you can enter your room details and everything, and you know people will come on the website and they will rent out this your one bedroom for for 1 day or 2 day or 3 day for a short trips, right? And you will get paid in terms of days. This is again an example of share economy. Okay, and very good thing is Airbnb, the research of the Airbnb shows the Airbnb users uses 63% less electricity than the hotel users. That is our number one. Number two, Airbnb have saved 1,160 swimming pool equivalent water for Europe. Okay, because Airbnb, research shows that Airbnb users uses less water and less electricity as compared to the hotel users. And yes, that's true. When we go to the hotel, okay, we don't care. But we, when we go to someone's house to stay for 1 day or 2 days, we are conscious, right, about the water consumption and the electricity consumption. So this is what the example of share economy. The third one is the optimization of economy. Optimization of economy, the example is, I think it's very common, minimize the waste from any process. Whatever the process we have, okay, because to do any work, hum koi bhi kaam kare, har kaam mein koi na koi process hota hai. Us process ke andar jo waste hai, agar aap usko minimize kar lete ho, to basically you are using the optimization of your economy, right? Then the third one is looping of the economy, loop economy. So there are, in loop economy, there are two type of economies again, a closed loop economy and an open loop economy. Closed loop economy is again is a synonym for the circular economy, and open loop is again a synonym for linear economy. Okay, you have to create a loop. Loop means, a very good example of loop economy is a company called Caterpillar. You must have heard about Caterpillar. It's basically, they are the heavy equipment machinery manufacturing companies, and since 1970 they have started this loop process. What they're doing is, they are selling a machine in the market. I have cranes, bulldozers. Okay, they are selling this in the market. Then when the life of this product is completed, they take this product back and they refurbish the parts from these products and they sell it back to the market. This is an example of looping. The another example is the DHL. DHL is a logistic company, worldwide logistic company, very famous company. They have just now, few years back, they have started something called reverse logistic. What do you mean by reverse logistic is, generally what happens, the product goes from a manufacturer to the buyer or to the user. But in reverse logistic, what happens, the product comes back from user to the manufacturer. This whole concept is known as reverse logistic, and this is governed by our DHL, okay, and DHL initiative, and they're really making very good money out of this, right? This is again a very good example of looping, right? The second last one is virtualize. Virtualize your economy, virtualize your processes. Okay, what is virtualized processes are? The best example is right now. Okay, I'm doing a live session on Facebook, right? This is a virtualized learning method, right? Otherwise, to share this knowledge, you know, we have to arrange a classroom setup. We have people need to travel, people need an infrastructure for that. Okay, and the purpose, the knowledge what I'm transferring as of now through a live session, the same knowledge will be transferred in the classroom as well, right? I'm not going to do anything different, but the cost and the infrastructure is required there. So this is an example of loop economy, virtualized economy, that we are going to virtualize most of the processes. And the COVID-19 corona, sorry to say, but this is a very good example that it has made the people to feel the virtualized economy requirement. And yes, I'm very happy to say that the whole world, whole industry, everyone is using this virtual platform very much. And we are approaching, by default, we are approaching towards the circular economy by using these kind of virtual economy methods. Then another most common example is your Netflix platform. Okay, Netflix is again an example of virtualized economy. Amazon Prime is example of virtualized economy. Okay, what they're doing is, okay, otherwise, like if you wanted to watch a movie, you have to buy a CD. It's a hard thing, right? Then it requires a process. Then after watching that movie, that CD is a waste for you. You can copy that in your laptop. Then that CD is a waste. So we in circular economy, the most major concept of the economy is we have to minimize the waste. So what the Netflix and Amazon did, it's just an app in your phone. It's just an app in your laptop. It's just an app in your tab. And you can watch n number of movies there, and you don't have any waste out of that, except your time, right? So this is an example of virtualization of your economy. The last one, last is the exchange of the economy, right? So in exchange of the economy, okay, again, I will take example of Amazon. You go on Amazon and you wanted to buy a mobile phone, right? Amazon will pay you back for your old phone. That is a exchange economy method. Then there's a new startup recently. It has been started like 1 year back. The company name is called Cashify. You just go on the website, you create your account, you just put in your old mobile phone details, and somebody will come on your home. He will collect the old mobile phone. He will pay you cash against that, and you're good to go. And what this exchange is going to do is basically you are taking the used material from the market back to the factory, getting it recycled, getting it regenerated, and putting it back into the economy. This is how the circulation of the economy starts, right? So, and there is no limit of circular economy actually. When I used to travel to Europe, in Europe, the people are far beyond one step ahead. Okay, they are talking about virtual circular cities. A great example of circular city is Netherlands. In Netherlands, there's a capital of the Netherlands is Amsterdam, right? And in Amsterdam, most of the things are basically shared. What they shared are, right? I'll just give you example. There's a one smart card in Amsterdam. You go and buy that smart card, and you just put some euros into that, like 40 euros, 50 euros, or 60 euros. And that smart card, you can use it for train, for trams, for buses, for water boats, transportation. And the same time, you can use that smart card for hiring a car. There's a company in Amsterdam called mywheel.nl. Okay, this mywheel company is what they are doing is basically, let's say I'm living in Amsterdam and I have a car. But my car, I have a two car, and one car I'm using for my office, and one car is idle at home. What I can do out of that? Right. I can register that car on mywheel. Okay. And somebody will come on the website. He will hire my car for 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hours. He will drive the car from my house, and he will come back and park the car again to my house, and he has to pay something to me. This is mywheel. Okay. Then we have a company in Amsterdam called Revere. What is Revere is basically Revere. In on Revere, what you can do is you have a you like to wear the branded clothes, right? But you don't have money to buy those branded clothes. What you can do? Either you go for the pirated one or the copied one. That is one example in India and in other developing countries. This is what we are doing. But in Amsterdam, in Netherlands, what they are doing is you go on Revere website, you register yourself, and the people used to list their branded clothes on that website, and you can hire those clothes for a week, for 10 days, or for 15 days, and you pay for a use, right? This is how they are sharing their car economy, how they are sharing their clothings. Okay. Then there's another platform called Ideate8. Ideate8 is what basically it's a platform where the professional can learn from the experiences of each other. Okay, it's basically a virtual university, right? And now if I say University means we talk about the classical education system. Like if you go for the Coursera, and there are some other website which provides the online courses on very set traditional patterns, right? You complete the course where you give the exam, and then आपको सर्टिफिकेट मिल जाएगा, ठीक है? ये एक सिस्टम है एजुकेशन का, बट क्या आप एक इंजीनियर से जिसने 10 साल इंडस्ट्री में काम किया, नौकरी की है, ठीक है, उससे ये सीख सकते हो कि उसको नौकरी कैसे मिली है, या उसने नौकरी में अपने आप को प्रमोट कैसे किया, उसने कौन कौन से स्टेप्स फॉलो किए, या फिर उसने क्या मेथड्स अपनाए जिसकी वजह से वो आज इस स्टेज पे पहुंचा है? वो नहीं, हम एक्सचेंज नहीं कर सकते, राइट? वो हम एक्सचेंज तभी कर सकते हैं जब हमारा कोई बहुत क्लोज फ्रेंड हो और हमारी बात हो रही हो, तो अपने एक्सचेंज कर दिया। बट इन एम्स्टरडम देयर इज अ वेबसाइट, ओके, वेयर यू कैन कनेक्ट विद द प्रोफेशनल्स, एंड दिस प्रोफेशनल कैन टॉट यू नॉट द क्लासिकल एजुकेशन बट नॉन क्लासिकल एजुकेशन, लाइक दे कैन टीच यू फ्रॉम देयर एक्सपीरियंसिस, एंड दैट्स द बेस्ट लर्निंग व्हाट यू कैन डू इज, राइट? देन देयर इज अनदर कंपनी कॉल्ड देयर इज अ अनदर कंपनी कॉल्ड इट्स नेम इज सर्कस, एंड सर्कस इज बेसिकली दे आर अगेन अ ऑनलाइन क्लोथिंग कंपनी फॉर न्यूबॉर्न्स एंड प्रेगनेंट मदर्स, ओके, एंड द टैगलाइन इज योर बेबी एंड योर बेली इंक्रीजेस बट नॉट योर क्लोथिंग्स, राइट? व्हाट यू कैन डू इज आउट ऑफ टू ऑन दैट वेबसाइट, यू कैन गो ऑन दैट वेबसाइट, यू कैन रजिस्टर फॉर अ सब्सक्रिप्शन, एंड दे विल प्रोवाइड अ न्यू सेट ऑफ क्लोथ्स एवरी 3 मंथ्स टू योर बेबी, फॉर योर बेबी, एंड आप हर 3 महीने बाद उन कपड़ों को वापस, वो कंपनी वापस लेगी और उनको नया सेट ऑफ क्लोथ देती रहेगी। ये सब्सक्रिप्शन बेस्ड मॉडल है, ठीक है? अगेन दिस इज समथिंग अ शेयर और एक्सचेंज बेस्ड इकोनॉमी, राइट? सो दिस इज वॉट अबाउट द सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी। सो जस्ट एज अ टेक अवे, यू हैव टू कीप 6 थिंग्स इन योर माइंड टू अंडरस्टैंड सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी। द नंबर 1 इज रीजनरेट, नंबर 2 इज शेयर, नंबर 3 इज ऑप्टिमाइज, नंबर 4 इज लूप, नंबर 5 इज वर्चुअलाइज, नंबर 6 इज एक्सचेंज। सो दीज आर द 6 मेजर पॉइंटर्स फॉर एनेबलिंग सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी, ओके? एंड फॉर द एंटरप्रेनर्स और फॉर द पीपल हु आर थिंकिंग ऑफ स्टार्टिंग अ बिजनेस, हु आर थिंकिंग लुकिंग आउट फॉर अ न्यू आइडियाज, ओके, फॉर देम आई हैव अ की टेक अवे इज नाउ स्टार्ट थिंकिंग ऑफ स्टॉप सेलिंग द प्रोडक्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, स्टॉप सेलिंग द प्रोडक्ट, दैट इज अ ओल्ड स्टाइल ऑफ डूइंग अ बिजनेस। नाउ स्टॉप सेलिंग अ प्रोडक्ट, स्टार्ट सेलिंग अ सर्विस, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? फ्रॉम प्रोडक्ट टू सर्विस इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम फॉर ऑल कंपनीज एंड फॉर द एंटरप्रेनर्स, फॉर द पीपल हु आर थिंकिंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू बिजनेसेस, ओके, फॉर देम इट इज अ की, स्टार्ट सेलिंग सर्विस, नॉट स्टॉप सेलिंग प्रोडक्ट्स। बिकॉज यू नो, जस्ट ट्राई टू इमेजिन, आई विल टेल यू सम मॉडल्स। देर आर कंपनीज हु आर लीजिंग आउट द मेडिकल इक्विपमेंट्स, लाइक मेडिकल इक्विपमेंट्स अगर मैं बात करूँ, सिटी स्कैन, एमआरआई, दे आर द मशीन विच आर गोइंग टू कॉस्ट इन करोड़, राइट? एंड एवरी हॉस्पिटल इज नॉट एबल टू बाय दोज मशीन्स। नाउ द थिंग इज, आइदर द कंपनी हैज टू वेट दैट द बाइंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द हॉस्पिटल विल इंक्रीज, एंड वन डे दैट हॉस्पिटल विल परचेज दैट मशीन, दैट इज द वन थिंग। द अनदर थिंग इज, लेट मी डिलीवर दिस मशीन टू द हॉस्पिटल एंड आई विल चार्ज हिम पे पर यूज। वट विल हैपन विद फ्रॉम पे पर यूज? बेसिकली वेन द हॉस्पिटल विल हैव अ एम आर आई मशीन, ही विल स्कैन द पेशेंट, ही विल चार्ज द पेशेंट, ओके, ही विल प्रोवाइड अ सर्विस टू द पेशेंट, एंड फॉर एवरी स्कैन द हॉस्पिटल विल पे टू द कंपनी, एंड दिस इज हाउ द इकोनॉमी विल बिकम सर्कुलर, राइट? सो स्टार्ट सेलिंग द सर्विस, बिकम अ सर्विस सोल्यूशन प्रोवाइडर्स, नॉट द प्रोडक्ट सोल्यूशन प्रोवाइडर्स, राइट? दैट इज अ की टेक अवे, एंड अ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल आई कैन गिव यू, लाइक फिलिप्स। फिलिप्स मैनेज द एंटायर लाइटनिंग सिस्टम ऑफ एम्स्टरडेम शिपोल एयरपोर्ट। शिपोल एयरपोर्ट इज अ मेन एयरपोर्ट ऑफ द एम्स्टरडेम, एंड दे मैनेज द एंटायर लाइटनिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द एयरपोर्ट, बट दे डोंट चार्ज airport for one time fix. They charge airport on monthly basis on every lux of light they use. For example, if they are using 1000 lux of light, so they have to pay for 1000 lux. Okay, lux is the intensity, light intensity unit, right? So you have to pay for this per lux, right? So this is a one example again of selling a service. So start selling a service. Then the last thing is about for the entrepreneurs, for the new startups. Okay, we have a mantra called rethinking of design. Okay, basically you start thinking of very innovative ideas, very innovative designs. Okay, but to adopt circular economy, okay, the main thing is we have to transform from rethinking of design to redesigning of our thinking. Once you are able to redesigning of your thinking, then believe me, you have adopted circular economy. I will give you a very, very great example which I'm seeing in last 1 month in India. In last 2 months, India becomes the second largest manufacturer of PPE kits, personal protective equipments, right? In that, they used to provide the cap, the entire suit, the gloves, the mask, the hood. It's known as PPE kit, which is used in hospitals. Nowadays, वो ऐड करके वो नॉर्मल लोग भी पीपी किट खरीद रहे हैं। अब हम लोग एक एक महीने के अंदर हम लोग वर्ल्ड के सेकंड लार्जेस्ट पीपी किट मैन्युफैक्चरर बन गए। बहुत अच्छी बात है। बट पता है, वी डोंट हैव अ मॉडल टू रिसाइकल इट। आज की डेट में आप सड़कों पे निकलो, रोड पे जाओ, आपको रोड के साइड्स में मास्क पड़े हुए मिल जाएंगे बहुत सारे। अब उस मास्क की ट्रेजिडी क्या है, उस मास्क को कोई हाथ लगाने तैयार नहीं है, बिकॉज जो 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 वर्कर्स हैं, जो जो क्लीनिंग वर्कर्स हैं, उनको लगता है कि ये वही मास्क है जिसमें कोरोना वायरस वाले पेशेंट ने पहना होगा। अब वो उसको टच करने के लिए तैयार नहीं है, ठीक है। अब वो मास्क रोड साइड से पड़े हुए हैं। आप निकलिए बाहर, रोड पे निकलिए, किसी हॉस्पिटल के आसपास जाइए, आपको मास्क ही मास्क मिल जाएंगे बहुत सारे, ठीक है। कैन यू इमेजिन उस मास्क को बनाने में जो पैसा लगा है, अब वो मास्क को अगर हम रिसाइकिल कर लें, ठीक है, तो एक तो हमने लीनियर इकोनॉमी से हम लोग सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी में चले गए, पहली बात। दूसरी बात, उस मास्क की कॉस्ट कितने टाइम कम हो जाएगी, कैन यू इमेजिन, या उस पूरी पीपी किट की कॉस्ट कितने टाइम कम हो जाएगी। सो वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट द री सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, राइट। एंड सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी को आपको समझना पड़ेगा, सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी इज बेसिकली अ बिजनेस स्ट्रैटेजी। इट्स नॉट जस्ट रिसाइकलिंग, इट्स नॉट जस्ट अ डिजाइन स्ट्रैटेजी, इट्स नॉट जस्ट रिसाइकलिंग, इट्स अ बिजनेस स्ट्रैटेजी, राइट। एंड द की टेक अवे, आई विल जस्ट क्लोज, आई हैव अ लिमिटेशन ऑफ टाइम, सो आई विल क्लोज माई टॉपिक फॉर द टूडे। द की टेक अवे ऑफ दिस एंटायर सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी इज, ओके, वी हैव टू रीथिंक ऑफ डिजाइनिंग एंड वी हैव टू डिजाइन आवर रीथिंक, वी हैव टू redesign our thinking, right? Rethinking of design to redesign of our thinking is most important to shift from linear economy to circular economy. And when the India is talking about self-reliant economy, I will say start working for self-reliant circular economy that will lead to a sustainable development. We will not लैंड इन अ स्टेज वेयर द चाइना इज टूडे। ओके, चाइना इज द बिगेस्ट मैनुफैक्चर इन द वर्ल्ड, बट चाइना की सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम पता है क्या है? चाइना बिगेस्ट मैनुफैक्चर तो है, लेकिन साथ में ही चाइना सबसे बड़ा बिगेस्ट कार्बन एमिशन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर भी है। आज के टाइम में चाइना की सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है उसकी पॉल्यूशन, एंड उसके बाद इंडिया, राइट। लेकिन अगर यही मैनुफैक्चरिंग सेटअप, यही डिजाइन, यही प्रोसेस अगर डिजाइन किए जाते बाई कीपिंग द सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी इन द माइंड, ओके, बिलीव मी, हमारा कार्बन एमिशन कम हो जाता और हम अपनी आने वाली जनरेशन के लिए कुछ छोड़ पाते, राइट। सो थैंक यू ऑल फॉर लिसनिंग मी, एंड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट फ्रॉम माय साइड, ओके। एंड वंस अगेन आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक कृष्णा फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू क्लोज दी चैप्टर विद दी नोट दैट ट्राई टू थिंक अबाउट इंडिया अ सेल्फ रिलायंट इकोनॉमी टू अ इंडिया, अ सेल्फ रिलायंट सर्कुलर इकोनॉमी दैट इज मोर सस्टेनेबल मॉडल एंड वी हैव टू स्टार्ट वर्किंग फॉर दैट. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर पेशेंस एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग. ओके, इन केस यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन सो यू कैन रीच बैक टू मी, आई विल शेयर माई ईमेल आई डी आफ्टर दिस सेशन. थैंक्स एवरी वन फॉर ज्वाइनिंग.